as well as friends. Good afternoon. Now the related queries related to the placement, related to the what kind of offer, soft tech offering and all things that Ishita tried to clear it up. And if you have any further queries, no issues, we'll take it in the Q&A session. But right now it's time to start directly with the MobiCloud training. That will be more beneficial for you guys. And you all are attending and curious about novel, all these stuff are there. So I'll be needing a marker, board and a movable mic. Thank you. MobiCloud or something. First of all, I want to devote some time on understanding what is cloud computing, what is cloud means, the conceptualization, and the many more, stuff or the knowledge what you are having over there. I just want to refresh it firstly, so that because like in the end of the my sessions, in the next second half is actually dealing with the practical issues. Actually, why you might be get one like question in your mind that here I came not for the guest lecture, but at the same time I came with a team over there. So my motive is not to just discuss your conceptual things are there that we can learn in the net as well as you can understand some of the things. Though you need some expert advice from our sides, expert comments. So first of all, I'll be giving you some basic techniques and tips about the MobiCloud and what the current research and the development in that. And the next half will be completely diverting on the what kind of research on the MobiCloud Axiom Soft Tech is doing at the same time. How it will be beneficiary for your career and all, right? So, first of all, if you understand the concept of a cloud, initially we think that everything which is in the format of web, that is cloud. Means many times now, even our trainers or sometimes now, what is cloud? Simple definition is web application is a cloud, right? But actually, that is not the complete answer. It may be the you may write 5 to 7%, but you're not completely right about this answer over there. Every web application is not a cloud. So now the question starts over here. What exactly cloud means then? Actually, cloud adds with the thing that is called the cloud computing, right? Means, let's say, I'll give you a very simple example to understand what is exactly the difference between web application and the cloud computing. Let's say you want to, for a job reason, you went to one city and there you need to have an accommodations. So what you'll be doing over there, you'll be just hiring a rented house. So if whenever you are hiring a rented house, means you're actually, it's a temporary arrangements what you guys are doing, right? That is the example of your web application. I want to go global, so organizations might be creating this web applications and put it under the global memory will hire for from some service providers and put it over there so that it will be accessible in the globally for all the clients over there. But why I am saying this is not a cloud? Because reason is there is no logic at all. Your clients are the complete dumb terminals, and there is no security at all. I'll prove this point basically because most of the time, right now, we all Indians are using Facebooks, WhatsApps religiously and rigorously. Have you understood one point, that how much data is secured in the old applications? Everywhere we are creating the events for the Facebook, we are every kind of possible data we are putting under the Facebook. But actually, who is the owner of this all the applications? We think that I'll be not making by making some permissions like a privilege settings, I can protect my data. But actually, you are wrong. on the client side, there is no kind of application is there. Everything is stored on the web. And the administrators of the who design that, because first of all, try and understand the point over there. Why Facebook is making a social service? Why he is offering everything free of cost to you? And if entire services to the clients he is offering free of cost, how will he generate the revenue and how is company going on? So somewhere down the line, there is a serious issue about the data security. We are not secured. The data is not secured. Our credentials are not secured. Now, for what reason he will be using, or for like, that is different issues, or he may or may not, or his purpose is to just collect the data and sell it out to the companies. That is different case over there. But there is, certainly there is some hidden agendas are there, right? So due to that, we cannot consider this kind of web applications as a complete cloud over there. But cloud means I should have, because like I was discussing one example. So you are hiring a rented house. Whenever you are having a rented house, you actually you are not going with your terms. You have to compromise with the terms offered by the owner. Now, cloud means actually we have our own terms. Just like, let's say, as per the family members, you may going for the flat, you may need a sea facing flat, you may need a like a flat in that particular premises. You need how many bedrooms you required, how many, whether you need a garden over there or something. So that specifications you are specifying. And as per that, builders will constructs, provides you the flat schemes as per your budget. And then you own that particular premises. That is exactly cloud means. Are you getting my point? Because if you, because obviously while coming for this forum, you might become prepared and Google out some stuffs about what is cloud, what is MobiCloud and all. So probably, as per the Google definitions, what cloud computing says, it's a software as a service. Everything virtually provide software as a service, infrastructure as a service, and a platform as a service. Now, the examples which I explained to you, that like, as per my requirement, I customize the flat and ask the builder to construct the flat, and I even given the budget to him. Means every organizations want to go global. Every organizations want to, because like because of the internet era, the entire world become a unique place. So every organizations want to do a global business. I'll give the simple examples. I'm just like maybe 3-4 hours will be here to explain you everything about the mobile cloud and how mobile will work and practically and conceptually. Now you will be the only one physically over here or the beneficiary of that. But right now also, if you if you make a live streaming and make it available throughout the world, so probably whoever maybe want to interested to know about these all the things, they can be also benefited by that. Means, and who don't want to go global? And obviously it's a beneficiary. We are not doing a business over here, so obviously it's a knowledge sharing, a forum we want to create out of it. So this is what basically the idea behind the cloud computing. It's a huge market, obviously next applications, because up till now, if you discuss about the application category, software companies are developing the applications. First, initial stage, we'll be developing a category of desktop applications, where the processors, your operating systems, your hardware, everything is in one machine, and the clients are taking utilities out of it. But as you know, because of the single user, single tasking system, it is having certain limitations. We can't share the data and the resources. So obviously, network we need to establish to share the data and resources. Then it comes the distributed computing, right? Client server architecture. Your cloud computing is extended version, or the virtual version rather I can say, of your distributed applications, right? And the third type of category what you are thinking about, that is web applications. But in case of web, as I said, we are just like hiring a virtual memory space on the rent. So whenever somebody explains you what is cloud, don't consider this a web application is a cloud, or the Facebook is a cloud, or some, because we are there is no security of a data. you cannot customize it, customize the credentials over there. You know? It means like to my builder, just like this, that simple example of renting house and flat. You know, that actually able to distinguish between what exactly I mean by the, you know, web applications and your cloud over there. Now, in a nearby future, all type of applications, as I said, like let's assume, I'll give some examples to you. Because right now, no, considering Indian environment, if I give the examples considering Indian environment over there, now what the government of India says, every year you need to, whatever the earnings you are doing, you make your own excess and then fill the income tax. And some advertisements also come over there, your daughter will feel proud, your son will feel proud about if you fill the income tax well, or it's a social will, socially rewards will be getting, and then they're saying your money will be utilized for the roads and the, it's like, I don't understand one point. It's like some sort of social awareness they are trying to make it over there. And I don't know, like, how many of Indians may be, you know, like, transparently and seriously giving their total annual income and this is the tax. I suppose instead of these kind of systems, if they can go for the global softwares by using cloud computing over there, they can have the clientele software, they can have a server software over there. Why there is need to, because I want to self claim that, okay, this is why my income sources. Now try and understand one point. If you disclose your truly income sources, you have to pay the tax even. So like many times we, like, obviously in a human psychology is there, we want to, like, we want more luxury and more lesser tax, so that money and all the things I can utilize for the rest reasons. That may be the human psychology we're building over there. So instead of government is coming with this social kind of things over there, they should have a strict monitoring about the income sources. They can easily do. For that reason, they can go for cloud. Get my point clear? So, monitoring and paying and everything will be, I'll give a simple examples, like, because the income tax example is not related to you. What I'm saying, why we are using a cash? There has to be a virtual cash. Why you use a cash? To avail the services, to get the products. Now, what I mean, why? Because, like, as we are excessive using cash, to get any kind of services, we fall in love with the cash, and we even do a puja of a cash. It's like good papers only. What else? It means I can buy something in the returns. So instead of that, if I want to buy certain services, I just want to. I can exchange in the virtually also, right? Paytm, you may, Paytm or with their no cash transactions are there. You can have, like, if everything of a banking transactions or the transactions of a buying and selling of a products and the goods done in front gone through the server of a banking server, that every transactions become a legal transactions. Are you getting my point? I'm coming to this level, and then that server will be connected to the RBI server. Now, like, instead of saying that, okay, if you are miss this slab level, taxes, no taxes on this level, slab level, this tax, but like everything will be self-proclaimed. I should disclose this is the things, like, I don't know, like, how many are that serious enough to disclose every possible actual income sources and pay the tax also again. So rather, if they come up with the concepts of virtual cash, there is no need to have a physical cash. If you go to the petrol pump, if you go to buy something, everything, every transaction need to be done from the banking. Next is, you need a virtual cash for that, all the reasons. So the security you will get, that no thefts and all these stuff are there. And like, because of the, for the cash, nobody will make a robbery or some. So this kind of mischievous things may not be happening. Second is, they may come with the concept that up to 5 lakhs rupees, because every transactions to the, because there is no virtual, there is no cash transactions. You should ban cash transactions. So even you jump that red light also on the road, your traffic police will say, why, what is the use of this cash then? Because he can't buy something, he can't buy some services out of this cash. Ban this entire cash. Now, if that policeman is asking you for the, I'm just like, sorry for that example, but like if anyone is asking for that for cash, now he have to prove from where this cash came. Excess money than the source of income. Again, like if you take 100 rupees from you and buy for that excess cash, you have to pay the 1,000 rupees as a penalty. Is he going to like take a cash from you? So entire corruption also stops. Right? There is no advertisement required. Imandari se bhar do, like in a social this thing, that thing. I suppose up to 5 lakhs rupees, no tax will be there. After 5 lakhs, for every transaction or every transactions, some percentile will be deducted. Are you getting my point? So, like, obviously the huge funds will be collected, and that all should be not be self-proclaimed. So, how they can do these all the steps? The simple example, they should go for the cloud computing, virtualizations of everything, and virtual cash. So, for that reasons, obviously, as I said, I'm just taking a simple examples to implement practically. They need to, as internet is not governed and not owned by a single person, in the similar manner, cloud computing cannot be owned by a single person. Certain services you need to buy. Certain services you need to shake hands with, right? That is what the software as a service means. I don't want to create my own software. I will take a software service from another creator. Infrastructure as a service. I want to go global. So my company want to go global, but I don't have infrastructure to go global. I can hire the infrastructure. As you know that every application required hardware, operating system, and the application software. Now cloud computing is a just distributed. Means you may have a hardware, you want to like take a help of another operating systems, maybe in the global, and you may take the help of the another applications over there, and your work starts. Means if the example which I have given you about the IT services, if that government of India want to implement, he want to, obviously some company may provide them the security of transactions. Banking servers will provide the applications things over there. Operating systems maybe want to, they can, it's a collaborative network. It cannot be a network of one user. There is a like in a cloud, whenever we are saying cloud, one can go for private cloud, one can go for public cloud, one can go for hybrid cloud. But the concern area is security, concern area, because we established a network, we established a cloud, we are going globally, because we want to share the data everywhere else, anywhere else. And like basically in the network, the biggest problem what we are facing about data sharing, that is, I need the confidentiality of data. I need the integrity of the data. I need the data availability. These are the network challenges what we are having. Confidentiality meta means if I'm going global, if I'm sharing the data among the networks, I'm not like basically confident that my data will be securely transacted. So I'm expecting the confidentiality, the integrity. The data should not be altered. The data should not be dropped. The packet should be delivered in the same position and the way from the sender to receiver. So that integrity should be assured. Then the availability of data. Nowadays, to understand one simple term, we want to go through the various books and then come up with the prior 10 years back, we need to study it. Let me tell you my example. How internet works, this was the problem. So for that reason, I need to go through 4 books. I studied everything, underline everything, and make my own notes, and then understand. Probably this is the way how internet maybe works. Now for you guys, just Google it out. And I just open the browser, how internet works, the diagram, everything, elaborations, maybe 10 different resources, providers maybe provides you the thing, the PDF and everything, and you can understand it. So why this is because of the virtualization is because of the global nature of the data sharing and all. Now, if this data sharing, we are going global, obviously we need that, as I said, confidentiality. It should not be accessed by unauthorized user. It should be like protected, data should be protected. Your service provider should be, give me the confidence that your data will not be hacked. Your credentials will remain intact. Is Facebook is assuring you? I don't know. Because like anybody can right click on it and save the image. Maybe use a Photoshop to do any kind of attacks on your images and put it on the social media. Because I'll feel Facebook is secure then only that he can restrict the, because fake accounts anybody can able to create. You can person like me take a photograph of a Salman Khan and create my image over there, and I can like. So what this point actually? I can use any kind of thing. There's no security at all, and probably the motive behind going for such kind of services is clear that they want to make a collect the huge data for some purpose. Now that for some purpose means obviously that purpose is hidden and they are earning money out of it. So business, every business, every organization is the service, and we are, as I said, the number of users are using the Facebook and the rest of the services because of the free of cost over. Obviously, I should able to customize. I should write my own coding of algorithms of data security, encryption, decryptions, compression, decompressions. That code I should able to integrate in my applications. Or rather, instead of HTTP, you should have a HTTPS. And so that the transaction should be secured, for that security socket layer should be working. So in that way, that services can be more secured. So now we understand the concept of cloud computing. Means cloud means nothing, something I put in the virtual space that cannot be considered as a cloud. There is some more services, there is some more securities, right? So probably to understand the concept of cloud computing, web application is partly, I can say, I'll give the percentile, that is 5 to 7%. We not need a dumb client over there. We need a intellectual client. Probably you understand the concept of a thick client and thin client, right? So I'll come to the mobile now. Mobile I can use as a thin client. I can program that mobile as a thin client, and then I'll connect my things with the my virtual server. Now in case of web application, everything is putting onto the one server. Everything is there on the one server, and your clients are the dumb terminals. We are requesting. So there may not be queuing system, there may not be data security system, nothing happening over there. There may not be a concept of a load balancing and nothing. So most of the time, whenever you try to fill some registration forms or you want to wish to your friend on the on his 31st of January or something, or 1st January of something, then probably because of congestion in the network, your mobile may be not able to provide services, your social networking may not be working properly because of the load balancing concepts are not used over there. So in such situations, if I take an example of cloud computing, clustering means I'll have a set of processors, I'll have a set of virtual machines, and my control server will decide to whom should I transfer the control to. So these all things need to be added. Thin client, I'll explain you the things over there. You are using a mobile, but this mobile got the various utilities available over there. Your mobile can able to view, you got the various sensors available. Your mobile can able to view, your mobile can able to listen to you. Nature provides us 5 sensors to view, sense, listen, and then we can process the data. Means if I ask you the question, or if you ask me the questions, how I am able to develop the answer out of it? I will read the question, send it to the processor will process it and respond back. Now, here in this case, as I said, in case of cloud computing, you want to make your client intellectual well. So which device I can use? The mobile. As I said, you in mobile, I can view the things. Means like, let's assume, I want to know who is this person, I don't know. So what I can do in this case, if I click his image, or I can record a video and send it to my server. My server is well equipped with the image processing logic. Because where I found some text also, I can mix it with that. So my image processing logic can separate the image and search in the database, that like the Google images you are searching for. Some text I write, pre-processing text, I put it over there. Text he will, text mining will extract the text. He will search for the image and the text combinations, and the best results what they get over there, and then he send the result to me after googling out by the image processing as well as the image mining and the text mining approach. He will give me the result over there, and mobile have a projector, and then that display will be here with me. So now, like the, I just click the image within a fraction of seconds, I'll come to know that he is Mr. Anand. He is doing some training in the softwares or whatever. Like, and imagine the situations if this person is unknown to me, and if I meet him, hello Mr. Anand, how are you doing? Like whatever stuff I expect, he'll get impressed, right? So means for every reason, my imagination has a limit. I can imagine anything else like this. So probably your search engines are now actually working just like text processing or text mining they're doing. Everything is a text oriented. You type the text and then goes to the. Good image processing algorithms. Obviously, if you are going with the images, so large and vast data will be like you have to compromise with the time and all. So you got a compression techniques applied, you got an encryption technique applied, you got a depression technique, decompression techniques applied, decryption technique applied over there. So for that reasons, on the cloud, I should able to customize it, all the algorithms, right? But to basically right now also, because initially we were using landlines, now we are in the mobile, and initially we are using mobile just for the calling, but right now we are using mobile to send some data. Mobile consists of various data sensors. They can even capture your gesture, they can even capture the room temperatures. Probably why your mobiles are not that intelligent, when you enter over here automatically, he should read the temperature and the AC should be on. Once you all entered over here, he should count the how many number of users are there, and chairs will be arranged. Chairs will be arranged accordingly. That sort of things are there. So probably by sensors, because your mobile having already predefined various sensors, so he can understand my gestures, he can understand my way of talking there, he can process the data, NLP algorithms you can use, any kind of stuff, sky's the limit. But the only thing in case of cloud computing, I want to disintegrate this processor, operating system and applications. So thin client can play his own role of collecting the data, pass it on to the server, here various virtual machines and as per their budgets may be performing the task. You may hire the infrastructure as a services, platform as a services as per your requirement, process the data in fraction of seconds, you get the results over there. So navigation systems, like the way we are thinking that, okay, now everybody is saying about the smart cities and the smart country and but I suppose instead of concentrating on the smart countries and the smart cities, we should concentrate on the smart people. And how smartly you are using these applications, how smartly you are using your mobiles, how smartly you are using your Facebooks without knowing nothing, and how smartly you are googling out some things over there, how secured your transactions are. Everybody going for the cafes and accessing the various applications, but have you cross-checked whether the keylogger system is available, so that whatever the ID and password, it's very simple to hack your Facebook account, believe me. Because many of you, to have a Facebook account, you are not typing the URL even, you type the Facebook. Now, do you know one thing? If I create a web applications, website even, not even the cloud, website, and just put a 1,000 keywords, Facebook, like this. So your Google crawlers will give a highest priority my application, my site over there. So when you type the Facebook, my Facebook.com opens. and you think that is the Facebook only. Right click on this. Now I will create the same, like, because download the Facebook, it's a HTML things over there, so that entire design get copied, you know? So it's not hidden over there what the coding Facebook is using over there. So you can save that page as a myfacebook.com. So what I will be doing over there, you type your ID and password. That ID and password comes to me, and then I will redirect to the original Facebook. So I'll get the ID and password. One time you accept the, then I'll change your password. So that your account is not accessible to you also. Any kind of, like, many kind of attacks can be happened because of the keylogger, that every, whatever the keystrokes you are typing in, on your machines, everything is recording. There's a different topic about the network security and all, but like I'm giving some examples. Like right now, it's making aware about these all the applications and how we can use that smartly, because these mobiles we are using, initially I suppose we are using mobiles just for the communications, that was good enough. But now, like, you're getting the mobiles which are the smartphones, so the vendors are making them smart, but if you don't use smartly, then you're in trouble. Because you got to internet enabled over there, because I can, you know, put a Trojan horse, so that if your mobile in the sleeping mode, I can switch on the cam, capture your image without knowing you, and transmit to my server, and I can do whatever stuff I want to do. If you are carrying the mobile everywhere else, so I can capture your images and videos also without knowing you, whether your mobile is on or not. So like any the sky is the limit, as I said, and I can customize everything. So one should know about what kind of applications parallelly running over there, and whether my mobile get hacked, mobile cloning and all these stuff is very, the softwares are available on the net. You can just download the software and clone your mobile and call to your friends by the same number, which may not be knowing. Any kind of stuff can be, like, nowadays, because of this using the things properly, many hackers are coming up and doing that mischievous things are there. Because, but basically, believe me one thing, it's they are seeking the loopholes what we are having while accessing and processing them, and then they are actually take help of the same thing and utilize that. So in case of mobile computing, we are discussing with the same issues. Why I discuss the securities and all these things, because of the reasons. Probably whenever you're going for the cloud computing, we need the secure data transmissions, we need the integrity of the data, we need the availability of data everywhere else. Mobile why is a mobile and a cloud? The reason is mobile having the various sensors. I can use it for any reasons to capture the data and pass it on to the server, and server can be processed, and then everything can be I can able to provide the service of. Now I suppose in this my discussion, as I am going conceptually over there, so I will shrink my discussions techniques over there, because basically practically probably my learning approach has to be more practical, because every time books, all the data, the books and data and all the conceptual things are available. So we want to go like bit more practical approach over. That's why I called a team over there to explain the things practically happening. So hope I able to explain you about your cloud computing and the integration of MobiCloud. So your web applications are not cloud actually, because you are just hiring something out of it. So you can give the 5-10% out of it for the, just like hiring a memory space, but you need to go with the private cloud, like where you can customize, you got a infrastructure as a service, software as a service, platform as a service, where you can distribute these processors, hypervisors we are using, we got a virtual OS. So these virtual machines, these are the examples of your cloud computing. Cloud computing means basically as per the clientele requirement, we can able to customize, but at the same time motive is I want to go global. So it will be, the physical territory will not become an issue for me. I can provide the services to all the clients or all my associates throughout the globe. So if we may be both client and me over here, but till then we are transmitting everything through the satellite, through the web services, your GPS servers are on, positioning is on, and able to provide the services. That is what about exactly your MobiCloud computing means. So I'll conclude my sessions here. Okay, I'll come back again if you got, whenever you got a Q&A and technical issues about these all the stuffs. But now, if you permit me, I'll stop my theoretical conceptual sessions if you don't have any queries, or if you have any queries about technically, we'll discuss later on even. And I'll hand it over this entire session now to my technical team and the team lead, that is Mr. Sagar, and he will take care about all the proceedings.